Using breakpoints for debugging your code lets you halt the project execution at the specific code position. So if a breakpoint is reached while executing the project, it halts at the position where the breakpoint is set and sets the controller state to the halted state. And the preconditions for using them are that the PLCnext Engineer is attached to the application process and switched to the debug mode. But first we have to activate the breakpoints, and we do it in the cockpit of the PLCnext Engineer by pressing this button in the top right corner of the cockpit and activating all breakpoints. We can do that in the online mode as well as offline. Now we can go online. Switch to the debug mode and enter our program code. From here we have to open our program instance by right-clicking. And now you can set breakpoints by clicking a function or on a variable. Toggle the breakpoint at this current position by pressing this red button right here. So let's, for example, do it with all add functions. So now we set the breakpoints and we can see them here in the breakpoints window. From here, we can execute the program by continuing it with this button in the top left corner. As you can see, it will execute it only until the next breakpoint is reached. The next button is step into the code. So that means that the program execution is continued until the next line or object is reached. So you will see by pressing it, it doesn't jump right to the next breakpoint. It jumps right to the next object in this case. If a function block call is reached, the code of the function block is opened in debug mode and stepped through. And that's exactly the difference between step over the code. So this does basically the same as step into the code. It just doesn't open function block calls, but steps over them. And the last one is step out of the code. So if we are in a function block code, it will jump out of the function block code and return to the calling POU. With those buttons here, we can enable breakpoints, either one breakpoint or all of them. Here we can disable the breakpoints and we can also delete them. So if we press it, we will delete all set breakpoints. And with this button here, we can go right into a code. So let's say we enable one, select it, and from here we can jump right into the code where the breakpoint is set. We can do the same with structured text. So from here we have to go to the program instance 2. And we can set breakpoints for specific lines. And yeah, step through the code by using those buttons right here too.